Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name's EJ Marino and this is About Last Night, the show where I talk about the movie I saw last night. We are jumping into a brand new review of a somewhat new, somewhat old film. Yes, we are talking about 2019's Child's Play. The new Child's Play movie is here, and this is a bit of a tough one for me to review. While I do enjoy horror and I love slasher movies, trying to start a new Child's Play franchise while the original one is still happening felt a bit odd to me. Don Mancini, the creator of the franchise, felt a bit disrespected when the studios tried to literally cash in on the name of the brand without caring about the characters or the mythos of this franchise. That's where I think this needs to be started off with. We have to talk about that first, but now let's move into this film. When it comes to this movie, the worst thing about it is the title. Change this from Child's Play to something like Best Buddy, or even naming the doll something different, but within the My Buddy universe, you could have made a slasher movie that felt like an homage to the OG Chucky movies, and not just stealing the title and slapping a brand new coat of paint on it. Look, this is not the worst movie I've seen this year. Hell, this isn't even the worst movie in the Child's Play franchise, but the 2019 reboot is a little lackluster in so many ways. Honestly, this felt more like an episode of Black Mirror than the actual Child's Play franchise we've come to know. The new twist that this is an Apple-like company that's making all these dolls and all the electronics around your house isn't as fresh as the filmmakers thought it would be, and it already feels like well-worn territory. Yes, we can't really do voodoo like we did in the OG franchise, but this felt as old almost as voodoo did as well. I'm not too sold on why they went this route. I do think it made for some interesting moments, for some interesting scares, but there wasn't really a dialogue we could have created here. There wasn't a lot that I could have really played with while doing this new AI tech version. Hell, I wanted to see more of these futuristic toys in the new Toy Story movie than I wanted to see in a Child's Play movie. I'm okay seeing Charles Lee Ray, the old school doll we knew. This new AI Robo Chucky is interesting in the idea and the execution. It just feels dated and well-worn territory by now. Let's talk about this new Chucky, by the way. I really think one of the better additions to this franchise is Mark Hamill taking over the role of Chucky. Look, I like Brad Dourif. I think his acting is still great. I still love those movies. But Mark Hamill added a fun new quality to something that I didn't think I needed from Chucky. That's one of those things I needed from this. I wanted to see something like the Mark Hamill voice in here and go, ooh, I didn't think I needed this in Chucky before. But yeah, like I said, adding in those AI stuff, adding in all that tech stuff isn't what I needed. But this Mark Hamill, this more sinister quality to him, he's still as fun as Brad Dourif can be. I mean, not like Bride of Chucky, Seed of Chucky kind of fun, but he's still a little, at least entertaining. You still want to watch him do all this crazy stuff. He also still scares me though. There's that sinisterness to his voice that I really enjoy. I do enjoy him the most out of anything, though I do love Aubrey Plaza as well. Her trademark snark and that charm works so well here. I want to see her in way more horror movies. Her and Mark Hamill need to find their way into more, maybe more prestige kind of horror movies, because they added something to this that I love. I will say though, the movie is gory and the scares are there. It does have a little bit more of a Hollywood feel to how the scares go. You know, when you watch those movies and you're like, 1, 2, 3, 4, jump scare. 1, 2, 3, 4, this is gonna happen. It has that kind of tension and it's built around that. But when we actually get to the kills and the gore, that's where I think of more indie films. That's where I'm like, ooh, this is a little bit more unexpected. Maybe I just saw Annabelle Comes Home and I'm kind of used to these more neutered kind of horror movies. But I saw this and I was like, oh, here comes that. Oh, I'm surprised by that. So again, I like that addition of gore, but these movies have been gory for a while, so that's not too new. But I will say for this movie, for a Hollywood production, I was happy to see that it wasn't scared to get a little nasty. It did not hold back in the kill departments, because that would have neutered this even more. The movie gets enough things right that I don't feel like it's a complete failure, but I found myself still wanting to see that OG series, or the newer films like Curse or Cult of Chucky, for my fix of this kind of movie. Again, if we would have just reworked this, changed a couple things, we would have had a really really new, fresh take on, or at least a new, fresher version of a killer doll story, and not just a, well, it's called Child's Play, so you'll see it. No, call this Best Buddy. Give me something in a Child's Play cinematic universe. Oh, I just can't believe I said that. But give me another doll. Give me something else, and I would have been like, ooh, this is new. But you will still have that back of your head of going, this is not the OG Chucky that we kind of know. So for you diehard Child's Play fans, this isn't going to win you over, and you might want to stick with the OG stuff. But if you're a casual fan or really craving a good new gory horror movie, I think this would work for you. Honestly, I think you're better off seeing this than some of the other entries, but if you're really a horror fan, I would say wait to Midsummer in a couple weeks. That's going to be even better than this. Yes, I used the end of my Child's Play movie to hype up another movie, but if we're going to be shamelessly cash grabbing and stuff like this, we're going to be promoting everybody. But yes, Child's Play, I think it was enjoyable. There's worse ways to spend your time with horror movies, but if you're an OG fan, this isn't for you. Thank you guys so much for tuning into this review. What did you think of it? Let me know down in the comments below. What are your feelings of this new Child's Play franchise versus the old Child's Play franchise? Let me know your feelings on that. Make sure you give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, because I make videos like this every single week. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and let's talk about some Child's Play.